In the previous tutorial, we got an Aldryn site running in a local environment. If you haven't got to that stage yet, you'll need to follow that tutorial first before returning here to continue. The help page of the Aldryn website contains a link to all the video tutorials. In this tutorial, we'll create a custom add-on for an Aldryn project. An add-on must conform to certain standards, but apart from some minor additional configuration required for Aldryn, if your add-on is well packaged, you should not encounter any difficulty. For the purposes of this walkthrough, we'll create a basic Django CMS plugin. See the Django CMS documentation for more information about developing custom plugins. This tutorial uses some code examples. You'll be able to find these in the Aldryn documentation. See Creating an add-on in the How-To Guides section. Here we are in the local development directory that the Aldryn client created when it replicated the cloud-based project. First, let's activate the virtualenv in the usual way. Aldryn has provided a directory called dev that's already on the Python path, so we'll work in there. We'll create a new Django application for the plugin. This creates a standard Django application structure. The first thing we need to do is create a cmsplugins.py file in the new application. It's beyond the scope of this tutorial to describe the function of this code, but it's fully explained in the Django CMS documentation. In brief though, this module creates and registers a new plugin called SayHello, which renders a particular template and can itself be inserted into a text-based plugin. Here's the plugin's template. It has to be in the correct directory. This new application needs to be in installed apps. However, settings.py is in .site, and we want to avoid touching anything there. Instead, we'll use the .env file we created in the previous tutorial to set an environment variable, referring Django to a local settings.py file in the dev directory. In local settings, we import all the names from settings and append our new application's name to installed apps. Try it out. Start the run server and add your plugin to a page. The special requirements for add-on packaging, in essence, an add-on.json file containing information about the add-on, are discussed in further detail in the Aldryn documentation. Here, we'll just go through the basics. Before we do anything else though, let's remove our application from the Python path by putting the entire Hello plugin module into a new parent directory. Here's the new structure in its parent. Doing this allows us to test the installation process without the risk of a false, merely apparent, success. Let's just reassure ourselves that the package is now no longer available. Now we need to package our application in the usual Python way. Here's a minimal setup.py file for our example plugin. Again, all these code examples are in the add-on tutorial in the documentation. We need a manifest.in file to take care of the templates. A license file is required. This may not matter very much if you're just using your application on your own sites, but if you plan to put it on the Aldryn marketplace for others to use, you should think carefully about appropriate license terms. And finally, here's the add-on.json file that describes the add-on to Aldryn. Now we can test that setup.py works as expected. And here's the proof, the run server works once more. Now that we're satisfied that our new add-on installs and works correctly, we're ready to upload it to Aldryn. The Aldryn client includes a validation tool that will report any problems it finds in your add-on. If that reports no problems, we can upload it with the Aldryn add-on upload command. The add-on is now in the Aldryn marketplace, in the owned by me list, which means it won't be publicly available, and it's ready to be installed. We install the plugin now, as we'd install any other from the marketplace. Once installed, we deploy the changes to the test site. And once that site has been redeployed, we'll be up and running and able to use the application on our Aldryn hosted site. This was a very simple example of a custom add-on. For a more complex add-on, some extra configuration will be required, but the basic principles are the same. More information can be found in the Aldryn online documentation.